LA Loves. Thank you so much for joining me here today. Today we are talking about the life of the Pisces woman. All right. So let me state before I begin, this may or may not resonate with every Piscean. All right. Okay. So here we have the little Piscean lady. Even as a child, you know, she is yet a little lady. And she is often a child who is raised in a family where she has siblings. You know, very rarely that Pisces goes up to be an only child. And having a family dynamic to her is a very important thing. Even at an early age, she realizes that, hey, I love being in a family. Her mother may be a bit albatross and, you know, hard-nosed, a bit stern, if you will. And that's okay with her. Their bond may not be as, you know, a mother and daughter bond, you know, playing house or having, you know, tea dates or whatever. It may not be on that level, but her mother is the powerful force in the house. You know, she's the lady of the house. She runs everything. And as her little helper, you know, she helps her mother, you know, helps her cook, helps her do the laundry. So basically, you know, being the sibling who soaks up all of the attention and is dutiful, gets all of the praise. And it's more so not wanting attention from her parents by being her siblings would consider as a goody two-shoes because they're a bit rebellious. It's more so she can get praise. You know, she just likes to be hands-on and to just be helpful, dutiful, if you will. And even as a child, you know, like I said, she's like a little old lady. Instead of being outside with the other kids playing about, she's on the inside helping mom, you know, with laundry, or, you know, doing her homework or playing amongst herself. And she kind of brings that sort of attitude with her as she becomes an adult woman, you know, having very few friends, just as many you can count on your hands. And if so, she may keep those, you know, at distance. But as a child, you know, she's the little girl who is very intuitive, you know, and once again, the Pisces, they're a bit clairvoyant. So she may pick up on a lot of things and see a lot of things as a child that many people may not understand. And this is what she kind of struggles with throughout her life, is being heard and understood. And typically during the ages of 7 and 10 is when she may experience some sort of, you know, trauma, or there's some sort of situation that occurs that troubles her throughout her entire life. Either she, you know, expressed this concern to someone and it fell on deaf ears, or, you know, it could have been a situation to where her parents divorced and it really, you know, had a dramatic effect on her. Whatever the situation is, something sticks with her. I want to say traumatized, but I don't like to use that term. But something sticks with her throughout her life, and it bothers her. And by this occurring, you know, this is when that whole sensitive side of her comes about, and she begins to tap into her deepest emotions as she becomes a young teen, you know, a bit confused. And by this being that way, this is what hardens her. She becomes a bit stoic in her personality, and this molds her character for the remainder of her life. You know, she becomes this tough, stern woman that's a little, you know, difficult to befriend. She's a little difficult to befriend or even be involved with in a relationship. And her challenge is not being heard and understood. And so she always kind of finds herself on the defense. You know, as a child, she may have experienced, you know, different episodes, you know, that seemed unfair. You know, she may have had issues with, you know, one child getting a bigger slice of pizza, or she receiving, you know, her snack last. So she always kind of had issues with certain things that just didn't make sense to her. And when she becomes a teenager, it becomes even more of a challenge for her, of understanding why people do things a certain way, you know, especially with, you know, friends, her young friends. Why would you invite her to the movies and not invite me over friends? So she may always find herself having challenges with relationships, either just a friend or an intimate relationship. And because of this, you know, she kind of stays to herself most of her teens, but she takes notice to guys. She has, you know, she's usually an attractive woman, probably tall and thin, and has this, you know, Victorian features about herself. And she's very attractive, and so she tends to hang out with the guys, or, you know, have a guy friend that she likes to socialize with. And these are typically the wrong type of guys, you know, because what she really wants and what she really needs is someone who's sensitive and who's going to cater to her emotional needs, which she rarely gets. You know, she may get the money or whatever, but always has a challenge finding a guy who can just simply cater to her emotional needs, you know, saying, "I love you." You know, it's one thing to bring somebody a rose, but then it's a little different just to be able to hear the emotion coming from that person. And she never really quite get that. But being involved with, you know, different guys, not really putting you out there like that, but you may have encountered, because you know, you were a knockout. But having these relationships, you usually become a teen mom in your late teens or your early 20s. And like I said, even as a child, you've always been a woman. So the Piscean lady usually marries at a very early age, you know, her early 20s. She's already a mom, but nevertheless, you're usually so steadfast and a virtuous woman that you always get your education. You're always about achievements. You know, you have your passions, and later on in life, you always tend to have two or three children. All right, it's a rarity where a Piscean lady has just one child. But even despite the fact that you have a family, your goal is to make something of yourself. If it's just simply becoming a pillar of the community, you know, you're probably a soror, but you like to be the face of someone. You know, you like to have a title. And you do just that. You achieve, and it usually comes easily for you. Your main obstacle in life is just probably maintaining a balance of emotion, and that usually comes because you haven't received the proper counseling or therapy for whatever trauma that you experience or whatever issues that you cannot get past. It follows you, and it makes you a bit, you know, a bit much to be with, to be around with. But those who know you, they just know who you are, you know. Say, "Hey, oh, that's her, I understand her, that's just the way she is," you know. They may not think much of it, but that's not okay with you. You want people to find out who you are. You like to be able to sit down and have a chat about your accomplishments and your achievements, and in almost in a boastful sense, but hey, whatever. You earned it, right? But yeah, and you typically do this while you're married, and you may even find yourself in a couple marriages, but despite of, you're never the one who wants to end it. You're a rock, okay? Meaning you like to remain, and even if you just you know, happen to go through a divorce, it sticks with you, because to you, that's, it has an emotional effect on you, okay? It's all about the emotions. And your sensitive nature, that you never can get quite under control, all right? But for the most part, the Piscean lady she turns out to be a virtuous lady. She's her own woman. You're very mystical, mystifying, and spiritual, very spiritual in a sense, with some religion or whatever. But you always find a way to, you know, meditate and keep your mind right. Even if your emotions are not in check, you always have a way of trying to just keep your mind right. So you can keep yourself together, keep yourself flowing. And this is the only way that you know how to basically get through life. Right? Is having some sort of spiritual connection, which is a great thing. And you do this throughout your life. You know, you're a mother and you're a bit overbearing and overpowering, but your children usually understand that. And they probably leave home early or will leave early. But nevertheless, they grow up to be whom you wanted them to be. And yeah, you usually live a very successful life despite your emotional traumas and distractions, okay? But yeah, that is all for the life of the Pisces lady. Be sure to check out the life of the Pisces man if you're curious. But that is all for now. Until next time.